Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to Story Time. Specifically, the story of being called by Microsoft tech support. Yes, it's our friends in vaguely Indian, very poor English accent call centres pretending to be Microsoft, telling me there's something terribly wrong with my computer. They had initially rung and woke us up at 8 a.m. on a Saturday morning last week. We asked them to call back at a more convenient time that day. They didn't get round to calling us back until Friday morning this week, by which time I had a virtual machine waiting for them to go play in. So we stalled for a little bit while I got ready for them, and then with a combination of an in-ear microphone thing and a separate audio recorder and some screen capture on the PC, managed to capture a sterling performance. Not the whole thing. Either they wised up or they got bored and gave up and hung up on me partway through. We start the story with nothing to look at and a female call handler with really either not good enough English or just her little headset boom mic wasn't all the way down. We could barely hear her. I will vaguely caption on screen what's going on. There's not a lot to it. And then we transfer over to a male scammer who does all of the work. There'll be some captions on screen of things I find interesting. And yes, this is what happens if you let the so-called Microsoft tech support, or one of the variations on it, scam in. Don't recommend letting them into a real PC. If you know about running virtual machines, then you've got the idea already. They're going to be playing in a machine that doesn't really exist. I did have some jokes lined up to spring on them, but never got the opportunity. They gave up before I could string them along all the way, and I was just interested to see what sorts of nonsense, lies, fibs, mistruths, and frankly misdirection, hand-waving, and dare I say bullshit, they wanted to pull. So without further ado, I will fade to black, we will have audio of Madam Female Call Handler, and then we'll get transferred in, and some video will come back once there's something to look at in the form of a recording of a virtual machine that they're playing in.
Okay, sir, I am Sophie. I'm calling you from Microsoft headquarters. Okay, this call is about your personal computer. Are you getting me?
Yes, I'm sat in front of a computer now.
I'm calling to inform you that we have got some warning reports from your computer, and the report is showing that your computer is infected by some infections when you're using internet, okay?
Okay.
And someone is trying to hack your computer, and the hackers are not only hampering the computer, but your personal letter and document files is also getting broadcasted over the internet, okay?
Oh, that's bad.
And it is not only about the computer, but it is also about your security, because your personal information is getting broadcasted over the internet, okay?
Okay, can you help me fix this?
So, sir, this is the reason we have given this call today, to show you the problem of your computer. And after that, we will help you to fix up the problem, okay?
Yes.
If you will go ahead, switch on your computer, I will guide you few steps. And also, you can check your computer by yourself, okay? Your computer is on now.
Yes, it's turned on. I'm sat in front of it.
Sorry?
Yes, the computer's on. I'm sat there.
Sir, are you in front of your computer right now?
Yes, I am.
Okay, sir, just wait. I will transfer my call to my senior, okay?
Sorry, I didn't quite catch that.
Okay, sir, just wait. Hold on. Don't hang up your call, okay?
I'm having trouble hearing you. This is a very bad line.
Please hold the line for a moment.
Hello.
Yeah, hello, my name is Marshall. I'm the senior technician from Microsoft who will help you, okay?
Okay.
So, are you in front of your computer at this moment?
Yes, I am.
And what can you see on your computer screen?
I'm at the Windows desktop. I have the icons on the desktop. Some of the icons have gone away, which is a little bit bad.
Okay, do one thing. Look at your keyboard. On the left side down corner, do you see a four-flag Windows key?
Yes.
You do one thing. You press the Windows key and the letter R. R like Russia. Windows key and the letter R together at the same time, okay?
Okay, yeah, that's Windows key and R. Okay, a box has come up. It says type the name of a program, folder, document or internet resource and Windows will open it for you.
You type in over there, letter E as in echo.
Okay.
V as in Victor.
Say that one again.
Letter V as in Victor.
Yep.
Then E as in echo again.
Okay.
N as in Nancy.
Okay.
T as in Tango.
Okay.
V as in Victor.
Yep.
W as in Whiskey.
Okay.
And R as in Romeo.
Okay.
Event VWR. Now you click on OK.
Okay, it's having a little bit of a think. It's doing the spinning cursor. Ooh, something's come up. Event viewer.
Event viewer.
Yes.
Yes. Now look on the left hand side of this event viewer window. What are the options which you can see?
There's custom views, Windows logs, applications and service logs,
okay,
it says.
You click on custom views. Click on custom views.
Okay.
Now what do you see?
In the middle there's an item, a list with one thing on it. It says administrative events, critical error and
okay,
warning
now
events.
Double click on administrative events.
Okay.
Now what do you see?
Ooh. Administrative events, number of events, 21.
In the middle, what do you see?
There's one thing that says, there's some that say error, some that say warning.
Okay. So tell me, what do you understand about these errors and warning?
I've never seen these before. I don't know what they are.
Error and warning are the dangerous online infections coming from the unprotected internet website. You got it?
Okay.
These errors and warnings are so dangerous that it can even crash down your computer. And because of these errors and warnings, we are getting the signals from your computer. Like whenever you browse the internet, there are some unprotected websites. And from those unprotected websites, the infections are coming inside your computer, okay?
Okay, so my computer's sending a call for help back to Microsoft, okay.
Yes. And let me tell you, these errors and warnings are not the simple viruses. These are basically the online hacking attacks. And the worst part about these infections is that it keeps on increasing every day.
Ooh, yeah, that sounds bad. How do we fix this?
I will tell you, but before that I want to connect your computer with the Microsoft server, okay?
Okay.
You do one thing, you press the Windows key and the letter R once again.
Okay, so Windows key and R. Okay, we've got the run box.
Okay, now in the run box you write down www.
www.teamviewer.com.
.com. Yes, now you click on OK.
Okay. Internet Explorer's loading up. Oh, I just need to get rid of some pop-ups and crap. One second, I'll have to do this. Okay, I have a website for TeamViewer, be right there, right
okay.
Now.
Okay, now in the middle do you see see a green box. Download TeamViewer.
Yes.
You click on download TeamViewer.
Okay, there's a couple of boxes. There's download TeamViewer, there's join remote control session, join online meeting.
In the rectangle box, the green rectangle box.
Okay, so just the one labeled download TeamViewer.
Yes.
Okay, so click on that.
Yes, now what can you see?
Okay, it's prompting me file download, security warning, do you want to run or save this file?
Click on run.
Okay, I'll click on run. Okay, another Internet Explorer security warning. Do you want to run this software? Name TeamViewer, publisher TeamViewer.
Yes, click on run.
Okay.
Now what do you see?
Nothing at the moment. Oh, hang on, it's come up. TeamViewer 11 setup. Welcome to TeamViewer.
Okay, now can you see there are two questions? The first question, how do you want to proceed? You click on basic installation.
Okay.
And below that, how do you want to use TeamViewer? Click on personal.
Okay.
And then you click on accept finish.
Okay. I've got the, do you want to allow the following program to make changes to this computer?
Yes.
Okay.
Now what can you see?
It's installing the little green bars going across. It's saying it's copying this, installing that.
Okay, now the TeamViewer software is getting installed in your computer.
Yeah,
okay?
Oh, it's come up. Check out what's possible with TeamViewer remote
control. Okay, you click on close.
Okay. Okay, that's all done.
Now, can you see your ID and password?
Oh, on the left. Your ID... do you need me to read this out for you?
Okay, tell me the nine numbers.
Okay, the your ID is 854...
Yes.
499...
Yes.
076...
076.
Yes, that's correct.
And what is the password?
And the password is 6438.
Yes. Okay, sir. Now what can you see on the screen?
A little box has come up at the bottom right. Session list, Microsoft Security.
Microsoft UK Security Department, right?
Yes.
So you are connected with the Microsoft UK Security Department. Now you minimize the thing and come back on the normal screen.
Okay, yeah, there's a little button to the side. Okay,
now what do you see?
I'm looking at the TeamViewer website still.
Okay. Close the website, come back on the normal screen.
Okay.
Now what do you see?
We've got event viewer open, and that's it.
Okay. Now look on the left side of the event viewer. Can you find any option like Windows log?
Oh yes, there's a Windows logs on the left.
Okay. Now double click on Windows log.
Okay.
Now what can you see?
There's new things in the list in the middle. Application, security, setup, system and forwarded events.
You click on system. I'm going to check the system part of your computer.
Okay.
Now what do you see?
Lots of information things, one that says error.
Now this information are the signals which we receive from your computer, okay?
Okay.
Like look on the right hand side. Can you see in yourself like filter current log?
Oh, filter current log, yes, I've got that.
Click on filter current log.
Okay.
Now what can you see?
there's a box come up, filter current log.
Okay, can you see critical error? You tick mark critical, you tick mark error.
So I put a tick in the box for critical and error.
Only critical and error. Only critical and error. Then you click on OK.
Okay.
Now what do you see?
It's only showing four things.
Faults. Like, are you watching these faults for the first time or you have seen it before?
No, these are all new to me.
Okay. Like, who is the owner of the computer, sir?
That's my brother. It's my brother's computer.
That's your brother. You are not the owner.
No, he's asked me to look after it. I do all his tech support for him. He's not very technical.
Like, it's a personal computer. It is used for the personal use, right?
Yes.
Like, what are you using this computer for?
I know he does his tax paperwork and his uni work, his work for his university course on it.
And how old are you?
I'm 22, he's 19, he's just in his second year at university.
You are 17?
I'm 22, he's 19.
Yeah, he's my little brother. 22.
Yes, that's correct.
Like, then you people must be doing like emailing, chatting, online movies, online banking, this kind of work on the computer?
I don't know if he does that on his computer, because it's quite old. It's a second-hand computer. It was an old work laptop from one of the places I used to work. Oh, something's happening without me clicking.
Yes. Like, is this the only computer or you have any other computer with you?
No, this is it.
This is the only computer. Now what can you see on the screen?
Some stuff has moved around without me clicking on anything.
Okay, the UK Security Department, they are doing it. Now what can you see?
There's a black box come up, says Microsoft Windows version 6.1.
What do you see?
Now it has run, NetStat, it's listed.
Network status, NetStat. Now, have a look on your screen. Can you see this address is 127?
Yes.
Now these addresses are the British address. These are completely safe, okay?
Yep.
But the beginning three address, these are not the British address.
Okay.
These are address from some Middle East countries. And they are getting established in your computer. Do you understand that?
Oh, so this shows us like other people connecting to this computer?
Yes, without your permission and without your knowledge.
That sounds bad. I don't want hackers and liars and fraudsters connecting to my computer.
And this is why your computer was sending us the signals.
Okay.
You got it?
Yeah. Okay, So what's doing this? How do we fix it?
Which protection do you use?
I don't know. As I say, it's my brother's computer. I just fix it for him when he breaks it.
Like, how many computers do you have?
Well, this is my brother's computer. I'm around at his place at the moment. I have one computer of my own.
Okay, like your computer and your brother's computer is connected with the same internet?
I know my computer's, I've left it at home, I haven't brought it around to his place because he said his computer was starting and it was getting on the internet.
Okay, have a look on your screen. Now, can you see a scan is going on? Hello?
Hello. Oh yeah, lots of...
Now what?
Now it says firewall security has been disabled. Oh, disabled.
Disabled. That's a mistake done by the scan. That's an input mistake. So the
Okay.
firewall security in your computer, which has been disabled, the internal firewall security.
That's not good.
Okay, now have a look on the screen.
Okay, we have a box up system configuration.
And in the system configuration, most of the services are manufactured by Microsoft Corporation. Can you see that?
Yes.
But not every services is running. Some of the services are stopped.
Okay.
Like in order to run a computer smoothly, each and every services should be running, okay?
Yes.
Like the hackers who enter your computer, the first thing they do, they deactivate your services because these services will never allow a hacker to settle down in your computer, okay?
Okay. That's not good.
You got my point? Now look at your screen.
Okay.
Now what can you see on the screen?
I have a notepad file. It says Microsoft Corporation, list of the services, removal of all the errors and warnings, removal of all the infections and virus files, installation of Microsoft Security Essential Antivirus, activation of Windows Firewall, making compatible the antivirus with the operating system, renewal of the Microsoft certificate. Okay, what's this? Okay. Okay. Yes. Okay.
And this form will be associated with your bank so that your bank can verify that you are paying £6 to Microsoft. Your bank will make sure that you are paying £6, and your bank will call you and ask you, are you the one sending £6 to Microsoft? If you tell them yes, then only the payment will be approved, okay?
Okay.
Like, do you have Google Chrome in your computer?
No, he doesn't like Chrome, so we've stuck with Internet Explorer on this machine,
Okay,
which might
Internet
be part of
Explorer,
the
like the
problem.
phone is not. It is an old version of Internet Explorer. The phone is not supported, okay?
Okay.
Have a look on your screen.
Okay, yeah, if you need to install Chrome for this to work, that's fine. I've been trying to tell him to put Chrome on for years, and if Microsoft says put Chrome on, then he can't really argue with me.
Sorry, I didn't get that. Can you please repeat?
I was just saying I've been trying to convince my brother to use Chrome for years, but now that Microsoft is saying he has to do it, I think I will win that argument with him now.
It's a fast browser, nothing wrong with it.
No, I like it. I use it on my own computer.
Okay. And who is the internet service provider, sir?
We are with Virgin Media, or on Virgin.
Okay, Virgin Media. Very soon I will give you the form. And in the meantime, sir, what I will do, I will install the Moit, like the Moito driver. Have a look on your screen.
Okay.
For the security, I'm going to install the monitor driver.
Okay, what does that do exactly?
That will make the connection more secure, okay? Now, sir, you do one thing. Let me open Google for you. Now, what do you see?
It's just loading. Okay, we've got Google page.
You got okay. Now, in Google, you write down Microsoft. Give a space after Microsoft. Then write down £6.
Yep.
And then after pounds, give the name of your bank which will verify the payment. Don't speak anything on the telephone. Without telling me anything, write down the name of your bank which will verify the payment.
Okay, and which bank will this be? This?
Just the name of your bank. Because your bank has to verify the payment.
Okay.
Okay, give me a moment. Now what can you see on the screen?
Just on the Windows desktop at the moment, your guy, the support engineer, moved the web browser away.
Now what do you see?
The browser is still there. I think you just minimized it. I'll bring it back.
You wait, you don't have to do anything. You wait. My department will create the form. Now what do you see?
I'm still looking at the search result for Microsoft £6 and the name of my bank.
I think there's some problem, you wait.
Yeah, now we've got a page for secure.logmein.rescue. And now they're installing some other piece of software.
Yes. You are getting connected with Microsoft Corporation. Can you see that?
I thought we already were through TeamViewer.
Microsoft Corporation, like it's the technician help desk. Can you see waiting for technician?
Oh, yes.
The technician who will solve all the problems in your computer, okay?
Okay.
And like, do you do online banking with Santander?
Hello? I do online banking. You, how do you know who my bank was? You said you couldn't see it on the screen.
I just got a message from the security department. They told me to ask you this question.
I don't do online banking with Santander at the moment. I've had a lot of problems with that and just getting the password wrong too many times. I have to go into the branch today to get the password reset, so I can't do online banking.
Okay, fine.
The app on my phone works, it's only broken to use on the PC. I can still use the phone app, so I can do that.
And that's the end of the story. They hung up on me and they never called back. Some things that I thought were very interesting from a technical perspective on how they were building up the scam event viewer at the beginning is obvious. They always use that. Clever use of NetStat, which shows ongoing internet connections and any network connections to and from your PC. And the 127 is the UK, it's safe. The 10 dot addresses are Middle East, they're all scary, dangerous. Please spare me. That's another one of those nice things that if you don't know anything, it will scare you and draw you into the scam. If you do know something, I think for a lot of these things, they want you to call bullshit on them if you're going to call bullshit on them so they can just move on to the next person. If you feel like playing the game, turn on dummy mode. Accept everything they tell you as gospel, go with it within a virtual machine. Don't let them anywhere near a real computer, but just smile and nod and let them draw you in and see exactly how far the rabbit warren will go for you. The fake scan with a variation of DIR to cause basically every folder to list out really, really quickly. That ended quite quickly because that virtual machine basically hasn't been used. It's not got much on it. Going into msconfig and looking at the services list and showing how a lot of them say current state stopped. Yeah, as I said on the captions, Windows services going to stop is pretty normal. A lot of them will get activated by other things or when they're needed, they go to stopped. This is one of those things like Event Viewer where there will always be something there on any Windows computer to look scary and to be used as the background to a lie. The short answer is Microsoft do not call you with tech support issues about your computer. Anyone who does is a liar, and hang up on them or string them along to waste their time as you see fit. Things that I thought were funniest, actually more funny than anything, was the supposed senior Microsoft engineer, as he introduces himself, sales pitching Chrome. Now, a senior Microsoft engineer would just dive into Windows Update and bring down newer MSIE. The fact that whatever web page they might have been going to bring up doesn't work properly in old IE. No, that's not how Microsoft do things. And of course, the typos of the results at the end of the fake scan, which is just someone on their computer at the other end of the TeamViewer connection typing stuff in, and they couldn't do it right. They corrected one typo that we pointed out, and then they left disabled spelt disabled, and I called them out on it, and then went, oh no, I'm reading it wrong, it says disabled. Really did test my acting ability to not just crack up and laugh the guy off the phone at that point. Other notes, £6 is way, way too small a payoff. They're up to something else, but I never managed to figure out what. When they were installing this monitor driver for TeamViewer, that's creepy as hell, because that monitor driver allows them to black out my local screen so I can't see what they're doing. They didn't do that at any point during the call before they gave up and hung up on me. But there's no way of easily knowing precisely what they would get up to behind that. There might be clever ways to rig a VM so that even once that locks down, you can get a sense for what's being done. Perhaps a keylogger and mouse move logger or something. The bank security call thing, where they want to find out what bank you are, so that when you fill in something or other on a website and then you get a call back from your bank confirming stuff, I think that bank security call is the meat of the matter. I had been going to say I don't quite know what they're doing, but it's just occurred to me while monologuing to camera to do this outro that actually I think that's it. They're not interested in being paid £6 for this rubbish work. What they're interested in is you being convinced you're being called back by your bank to do a security thing, and then will ask you security questions necessary to either get into your online banking or otherwise to abuse your bank account. So it's the tech support scam cross with bank call scams. And why on earth would they need the bank to get involved? Why would they need to know what bank I am? Surely it's 2016, they would take a card payment. Microsoft take card payments perfectly well. I know this, they get one from me for Office 365. Yeah, I think that's going to be it. It's a bank job type scam, but there may also be let's load your computer up with additional malware stuff while they did the monitor blackout driver. Unknowable. And I think the call fell apart at the end, either because I pushed back and got suspicious on why did the man on the phone say to me about Santander when the background thing he's trying to push is that he's not looking at my screen, which is why he keeps asking me what's on screen, and for typing in Microsoft £6, the name of your bank, into Google. Like, don't read out your bank name, just type it in. Of course he's watching over TeamViewer. And either that killed the call, or when I prevaricated about being able to do online banking and oh no, I can't, as I explained in the captions, Santander is not my bank, therefore no, I can't log into Santander online banking, even if I was willing to go near online banking while having a connection open to these bunch of thieving charlatans. And now it's time for me to go reformat that virtual machine. One final footnote, neither of the two remote support companies you've seen in this video are bad people. TeamViewer, I actually use for myself and I like it. I use it to tech support my parents and remote friends and relatives. It's very useful, which means I know it fairly well. And LogMeIn service as well. They provide commercial remote support things. It's very convenient. But no company will ever call you up out of the blue to tell you there's something wrong with your computer. You will know if you have an ongoing support contract with anyone, and even then, the odds are vanishingly unlikely that they will call you up and go, there's something wrong with your computer. No, the only something wrong is the person on the other end of the phone who wishes to rip you off. Yeah, I've run out of my little shopping list of notes on that screen behind this camera, and I think I'm done talking, so thank you very much, play safe, and feel free to lie to scammers and waste their time if you find it amusing. Bye!